guys, so today I have a bit of a berry lip tutorial slash haul for you, and I'm going to start off by saying I'm really sorry if I'm a bit nasal in this video, but I've got a cold unfortunately, and secondly I'm also sorry if I go this whole video or halfway through this video or whatever with lipstick on my teeth, but you know, it can't be helped. So firstly, I'm just going to tell you about this website that I've teamed up with. It's called These Details, and I will say that this is not a sponsored video in any way. I am not getting paid for this, so don't worry. But I want to share it with you because I think it's absolutely fantastic. The concept basically is that, you know, when you're online shopping and you get your four pictures that you see, the models that model clothes on websites are usually 5'8" and above, and that is a problem for me because I'm petite. I'm only 5'5", the half an inch counts. But yeah, if you're the same as me, most people are not 5'8" and super slim or whatever. So basically, These Details believes that those four stock photos are just not enough to tell you about a product, about whether it's going to fit you, about whether it's going to look nice, or what colour it is, the fabric, whatever. So on their website, they actually put up reviews from normal people. It's basically like watching reviews on YouTube, but it's a whole website full of them, which I just think is fantastic. So I thought that I'd tell you about that. So now I'm just going to get into my own little haul, and I have been after some berry lipsticks for ages, but not just any berry lipsticks. I have a few dark reds, and this one that I'm wearing is one that I got, and it is dark. It looks more red on camera. It is very purpley, but I really wanted some purple, deep purple plum shades, basically. So that is what I got. I got two lipsticks. One can sort of be built up if you're not really into a bold lip and you haven't worn one before and you're just sort of trying it out. That is a great one to go for. The other one is very daring. It's very dark, but I love it, and I think it would be fabulous for a nighttime. And I also got a lip liner. I'm going to show you the lip liner first. It is this one by MAC. It's called Night Moth, and it is basically a really, really dark purple. It's almost like an aubergine sort of shade. It is gorgeous. When I'm wearing dark shades on my lips, I just like to use a lip liner as a base. I just think it allows you to put your lipstick on so much easier by outlining it first, and also filling the whole lip in with the lip liner helps because it just gives the lipstick a base to stick to, and also you've got your colour already. So when your lipstick rubs off throughout the day after you've eaten or whatever, if you have your base on underneath, which is this, then it just doesn't look like anything has shifted, basically, because you've still got the colour underneath. So the first lipstick that I got is this one. I've got it on today. It's the more buildable of the two shades. So if you're new to a really dark lip, then this is a great one to start with, I think. It's Charlotte Tilbury, if I haven't already said. It's called Glastonbury. Get it? Love it. And it's just a gorgeous deep plum shade. It's got a lot of red undertones rather than purple. It is still purpley, but like I said, it's red, so you can actually, if you don't want to go all out into a whole bold lip, you can just sort of pat this on and work yourself up to it. If you're a little bit sort of on edge about it and you're a bit unsure, you can work yourself into it with this. It just adds a really nice sort of deep berry reddish sort of shade to your lips, and I just love it. And you can put a little bit of lip balm on or something on top. That's another thing about this, it's really moisturizing, so it doesn't dry out your lips at all. Love it, which I love in a dark lipstick, because sometimes if they're too dry, they can just make your lips chapped and it's really, really noticeable. But this doesn't do that at all. It is gorgeous. And can we take a moment to appreciate this rose gold packaging? I am a sucker for packaging. This is amazing. The next lipstick that I have to show you is by my favourite makeup brand of all time. I probably don't even need to tell you what brand this is. You probably guessed already. But it is a MAC lipstick. This is daring. It is just so beautiful. But I think for me, I will probably wear this at nighttime. It is a gorgeous, gorgeous, deep plum shade. There is no red in this. It's completely plummy. It's almost black. I just think it is so beautiful. I got this for a nighttime, actually. I think that this is an all or nothing lipstick, to be honest. I don't think that you can build it up as with the Charlotte Tilbury one because it is quite purpley blue based. So I think if you just put a little bit of this on, it would just look a bit like you had frostbite, which is never a good look, is it really? But yeah, if you're after a really, really bold lip or a really standout lip for a night out or whatever, even during the day, I would probably wear this during the day as well, but I did buy it specifically for night times, just when I want a really, really bold pop of colour. Do you know the look that I was thinking of, actually, when I chose this lipstick? I was thinking of the White Witch out of Alice in Wonderland. You know how she's all dressed in white, she's so beautiful and fair, but then she's got these really dark, dark lips. That is what I was thinking. So I'm thinking just a really simple face, maybe something just neutral to wear, but a really, really dark lip. That's what I was thinking. And I just think these two shades are absolutely perfect for winter time. I love them so much. I'm actually so excited about them. So that is my little haul slash tutorial, guys. If you would like to visit the These Detailed website, I will leave all of the links below. So you can go and sign up and check out the reviews that are there if you want. Also, exciting news, they're looking for reviewers at the moment. So if you fancy doing that yourself, I'll leave the link below. You can find it on their website, but it's got all of the guidelines and everything on. All you have to do is submit a written or a video review to them. Yeah, that's pretty much it, basically. Let me know if you do, because I'd love to go and watch your reviews. I'm a bit nosy like that. And I'd absolutely love to see what you're wearing and what you're buying and all that sort of stuff, because I like to get inspiration for myself and all that stuff, you know. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I really, really hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you soon. Also, I am uploading 2 videos per week from now into the foreseeable future. So I will be uploading on a Sunday as usual, and someday during the week, probably a Wednesday or a Thursday, but we'll see. So keep an eye out. I will tweet about it, so follow me on Twitter and Instagram and all that stuff if you haven't already, to be sure to find out when I am posting videos. So that is it from me for today, guys. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, and I will see you soon. Bye!